Hi, I'm Ani. I post weekly web design tips and tutorials that are easy to follow along. Today, I'll show you how to build this interactive product slider. This idea can be applied on any type of product. Here, I'm showing sunglasses, but imagine it could be anything, like a bike in the background and different attachments are sliding on and off the bike, or a phone in the background and different phone cases are sliding on and off the phone. Only your imagination sets the limit. If you want ideas for your clients' sites, just comment their product and I'm happy to help. I start with a blank studio canvas in Wix Studio. Add a section and a background to the section. This image is the part that will be static, so in this case the woman, and the sunglasses will be added in a slider on top of this. You'll find the slider we're going to use under Layout Tools and Slideshow Repeaters. By clicking this icon in the top right corner, we're stretching the slider to cover the entire section. Make sure this slider is transparent by adjusting the background to 0% in opacity. All the slider elements are editable, so adjust them to fit your design. To make this easier to maintain in the future for your clients, you can even connect these slideshow repeaters to Wix Studio's CMS, where you could store all the information about the products and dynamically apply them to this design. Now I'm adding an image, and this is the image that will hold the product photo. So I'm just replacing the image with the first pair of sunglasses. And then I'm just arranging the sunglasses to fit perfectly on this woman's face. I think this looks pretty good, so now I'm just gonna populate the other slides. To do that, just select the slideshow repeater and click Manage at the top right corner here. You'll see all the slides have gotten the same styling as you've just applied to the first slider, including the same image. Just click the image to replace with a new product photo. This will only change the photo on this slide. Any text edits you make to the individual slides will also only apply to the individual slides. Now I go back to edit the slideshow repeater to change the product photo on the last slide. And then I change the product name. I'm just doing this manually here, but if you have a CMS connected, you could connect this field to your CMS in Wix Studio, and that would automatically populate this field with the values you've stored in your CMS. To add another slider, just go into Manage the slideshow repeater and duplicate one item. Now I just customize the final slide. I usually publish the site to view how it will really look for the visitors. So this is how it would look now, and I'm not quite satisfied, so that's why I'm going back in and doing some more editing. You really can edit any element of the slider, so I decided to edit the slider buttons, the arrows, to make them more on brand for this website. I also want them bigger and more prominent because they're such an important feature for this effect. I also tried out a few different animations on entrance, but decided that was not really the way I wanted to go for this site. After some tweaks, the design now looked like this on desktop, which I'm very happy with. Depending on your settings for each section and element, the Wix Studio sites are more or less responsive by default, but usually I like to make some tweaks because for this design I really want it to look like this on mobile. I love that I have full control over the mobile design in Wix Studio, so just select the mobile view and any edits you make here will apply only to the mobile version, keeping the desktop and iPad versions intact. Editing in mobile view works just exactly the same as editing for desktop or iPad, so just make edits and preview as you go. And as I said, if you want ideas for how you could use this slider effect for your product, just leave a comment and I'll be happy to help. Now you have this really cool interactive product design for a website built on Wix Studio that works just as well on desktop and on mobile.